Dire team ban. Radiant team ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Dire team ban. Radiant team pick.
Alchemist.
Dire team pick. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Yeah, it's looking pretty good. A little bit interesting. So typically, when you want to go for something like this first pick Alchemist or anything like that, Slardar are definitely number one priority. I would actually consider it more of a priority than the Ancient Apparition, as they've shown here, simply because Slardar is so good against Alchemist. You get the minus armor on top of him, you get the lots of lockdown using the Slithering Crush and the bashes, make sure he can't get off that ultimate, surprise him from the fog, you know, basically in all kinds of ways, he helps counter up against the Alchemist. But then, rather than going in towards something like the AA ban, since they are going to first pick and everything like that, they do ban out the Tusk, simply because I think you don't really want to get Tusk paired up with another high quality hero on the side of EWolves, and I think they're trying to force him to take this AA pick early, but in response the EWolves actually do answer back with the Bane. So that means now, unless they want to open up with both Bane AA right now, the chances are Archon's actually going to be able to ban out the AA this time, and frankly it didn't do that much work for EWolves last game anyway, so they might be a little bit hesitant to pick it up this time. Looks like they'll take the other blue support and the Winter Wyvern.
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Yeah, and I also like it because we saw Moo just running around the map, causing complete and utter chaos, and Winter Wyvern and Bane, the two of them are much better in terms of dealing with the aggression. Like, you had the Bane before, but like being shown off by Whitebeard there, and we already saw kind of how he was used aggressively simply because they were leading so much, but EWolves will definitely be able to use some TPs from Winter Wyvern and the Bane, help keep their heroes alive from this rampaging Alchemist there, and they'll go with the Undying next. So one good thing about that is that, you know, Undying, he's always fallen off in those later games, but if you can throw the Aghanim Scepter on top of him, still does relatively well.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Radiant team ban. Ten seconds remaining. Dire team ban.
Juggernaut.
Radiant team pick.
Yeah, it's I don't know. The thing about Archon is that we
Yes,
don't really know what
Cobra.
direction they are gonna go. Like, we talk about how, oh, they could throw
Dire
the,
team
you know, the
pick.
Aghanim Scepter on this guy, but they still have it open even with this Earthshaker pick. Like, do we want to go back towards that Radiance pick? Like, do we want to go towards something where I am gonna be handing out the Aghanim Scepters, or are we just gonna run at them? Like, are we gonna pick up a Pugna next or something? Just throw it with our Undying. And I'm leaning towards the run at them draft. And I agree with you, it is
Templar
gonna be a little bit hard for them to
Assassin.
deal with it. They will have the Templar
Radiant
Assassin. That can be
team
very nice
infiltrate.
for a lot of reasons up against Archon. And then they go back for the
Dire
PL.
team
So
back.
a little bit mid-game oriented, but what the TA is gonna do is that she does provide a lot of vision that they are lacking, and especially in the Roshan pit, because this early medallion, you get it when you're going Radiance build, you can
Radiant
do it whenever you
team
want.
back.
It is really important. And how Alchemist likes to snowball his entire team, and we saw that, like, propel them right into that mid game. And so helping to keep an eye on Roshan can be a really big part of that for EWolves.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Dire team pick.
I don't know, that axe is like, I don't even know where they would lane that. And it looks like they'll go back for that. That's kind of a little bit
Radiant
of a
team
classic in
pick.
terms of a lot of South American teams. You know, we've seen it from like Knot and the boys before, and we'll go back for that Nature's Prophet. And I mean, you talked about how they had a good time with the split push before, so Juggernaut pretty good at that as well, right? Like, there's nothing that's going to cancel this BKB unless you know, get a basher or something, or well, rather the spin, like spin TP from the Juggernaut, so they can kind of make their space on the side lanes, go
Bounty
for something like that
Hunter.
Manta early on, and try and split push it out. And speaking of split push, it looks like they'll be keeping an eye on him with Fluff on that Bounty Hunter. Somebody's making a little bit of a comeback lately, you know?
Prepare for battle.
And it'll be M-God over here for EWolves throwing down a ward. And then Van gonna be on the Nature's Prophet. It'll be a Iwo there on the Juggernaut. Smash heading to the mid AKMMR.
30 seconds
I just
to
feel like
battle.
saying that every time right now on the TA. And then Masoku gonna be on the Winter Wyvern. So I feel like once you've reached 8K, that is definitely something you've earned, you know? Like, you should at least try and throw it out in the cast as much as you can. Cause, especially because he was probably grinding it out there. Like, he's a deal with US East first off.
The battle begins.
We'll
The
take
seeds
that.
of war. First blood.
Last of my kind, but first in this.
Yeah, we got this tri-lane made here from Archon. Everyone's trying to figure out where they want to go. The five melee line up here from Archon. Definitely not something you see very often, speaking of which. So we have seen it a little bit more often simply because of like Tusk Undying and stuff like that was run a couple times in the majors, and if you couldn't get your hands on a Dazzler or Winter Wyvern, who even needs ranged heroes, honestly? Let's go. And it's just, I don't know, it's just so comical just watching. Obviously it'll affect the experience in terms of Boo, but they've sort of smashed enough that he's actually still tied at the same point as them, so I don't know, going fairly well there. And the bottom lane, Fluff, he's kind of keeping an eye on Vance, seeing what they're up to, but it is giving J.O. a chance to farm. And he doesn't have the Quilling Blade though, and it can be a little rough with PL simply because his right clicks are so unreliable underneath the tower. And Monkey's looking spun on up top and slow down there as well, and he will drop under the tower.
Never will you see my face.
The wages of fear.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Yeah, and so we've kind of got like EWolves are, in a sense, sacking Smash. Like, there's no rotations to do anything. And then up in the top lane, you've kind of sacking poor Monkeys again. You know, two deaths already, three last hits. And I don't know. Last time, it kind of seemed like it was Dire's the burden was on Mu, right? Like, he had to move around a lot. Make some space, get some kills there for Monkeys, and man, J.O. is just trying to trade up against M-God, and he's like, yo, I have Brain Zap, I don't know if you know about this hero. Tails going? No!
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Double kill. Killing spree.
So vile.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
I don't even know, honestly. Everyone's just dying. Dire's, I don't know, maybe Archon, simply because they just kill Monkeys again, is one of those kills, and I mean, really, what does he have to lose at this point? Like, there's phase boots out on Iowa, so it's just, like, instant kill. But Mu will be going back towards the medallion, and that still doesn't determine completely what he's gonna go for, but when you're up against a TA, like, if you want to get this early blink and solar crest and everything, that's so good against her. Like, you're going to be giving her the shine, so she'll be missing out on her right clicks. You're going to be taking away the refraction charges with the acid spray. You want to be involved in every fight that she is. I'm fully expecting to see the train go again, and it looks like MKGOT's going to get Moo here. Oh, one more! Yeah, a lot of this has to do with the whole 5 melee lineup. Like, Fluff was down here bot a little bit, but when you're using the Bounty Hunter, a lot of that's, like, usually he's harassing the mid lane. That's what makes him so powerful, right? But in this lane, we have an Undying sitting here the whole time instead. So Fluff's relegated to this supporting the safe lane versus a Bane and a ranged hero in the Nature's Prophet. So it's very difficult for him to get a lot of harass and trade properly against something like that. And he can't zone anyone out, and there will be TP in from Van up top onto Monkeys again, having a really rough go over this game.
Surgical.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's top tower.
Yeah, and this has actually opened up a lot of space, at least for Jayo. You know, he's starting to claw his way back about 700 more in terms of net worth compared to the last time we checked up on him here. And I don't know, I'm kind of excited because PL, he fell off a little bit, right? And I want to know what Jayo's going to do this game. Like, you're in this position where you really don't want to be on PL. Like, he's kind of someone who relies on quite a bit of early on farm. If he wants to contribute to these early on fights, he might need something like a bottle. And speaking of early on fights, it looks like Moo will get nightmared up here in the mid. I will come back in. Doesn't have the Omni Slash this time, though. So Whitebeard throws down the Tombstone, but I don't think it's going to be enough, even with the Soul Rip. And now he just gets sprouted up. So they'll come on in, and Whitebeard tries to stack himself for the good of Moo, but he will in fact just die as well. And leaving Fluff all alone up here. Doesn't even have track to keep an eye on them. He could secure that bounty.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant structures are fortified. Dire's top tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
Oh! We have a dagon! Yes! We have a dagon on Prophet. Let's go! We got Dota 2. He's coming in on top of Monkeys right now. Yes! Dota!
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Look, they're snowballing. Jayo has nothing. Like, let's just go. Let's group up. We want to fight. Prophet wants to be
Radiant's
useful.
He,
who needs
attack.
These, you know, normal items like a necro book or any of this nonsense? Like, just get a dagon, burst down that alchemist before he can pop up his ultimate. Undying's still relatively squishy. 800 HP. You got a bounty hunter who's, what, level 5? He's sitting at 600. Monkeys, I don't even know. They're probably sitting over there on Dire. Like, wait, they have an Earthshaker? Like, he's sitting at 830. Van's a player. Like, this guy's, he wants to fight.
Thank you.
Oh no. Is that the only reason?
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Radiant's oh my god. Is under attack. He's body blocked by the trees! I'm still not over this Dagon. I want to see him come back in. Like, let's go, Van.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. Dire's top tower is under attack. Dire's structures
nice.
Are fortified.
I must be dreaming.
Really? Oh, top.
Uproot and after them. Lie fallow in your grave.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
And now Smash is gonna find monkeys at the bottom rune, and TA trap will slow him down, but Jayo's coming, the refractions are being burned off, and Smash is gonna TP monkeys, he's trying to get in range! I can't get it. He got a little bit too scared that time, so Smash does make it out. Alright. I don't know. It's good. Like, Evil saw that last game where Moo was just diving around all over the map, and like, oh, that looks like fun. We should have done that. Like, let's try that. So here we are. Oh, Moo, top lane! Oh, that was like all of his HP! Moo didn't even have my... Oh, he didn't even have the acid thrown down for the extra minus armor. That could have been even more devastating looking, but not really much you could do. He probably could have won his curse if he wanted to live, but not really worth it in this case. And they'll have the rush on. In fact, it's actually so early on that he can respawn in time to fight here if Archon are going to contest, but it looks like this one will be free. Well, for Fluff, he is gonna head towards the Vlads this game. A little unusual. Usually it's like the Mech Greaves or something. So he's gonna go on MGOT here. There's no time to talk about items builds. It looks like Moo's gonna be blinking in here. He's gonna have the concoction ready. Gonna get away those trees. So clear sight lines for Moo. And again, not using the acid spray. I guess I'm just figuring he doesn't need it. But either way, these, like we talk about how there's gonna be a lot of skirmishes and both teams have itemized for fighting. Like they are gonna fight. Jayo, not so much. You know, he's pushing lanes. But the other nine heroes in the game are. And that is where Track will come into play, right? And that is going to affect, it's going to be great for Archon, but they have to, of course, win the fights, and if they actually have to face the full five man of EWolves, it could be a little bit rough there, and that dust comes out. I guess he was trying to find a bounty hunter. They will find him with Winter's Curse. Oh, the Omni Slash is ready and willing. Moo, get the ultimate off. It's going to be close, but Iwo continues on top, does not get sent over to Whitebeard there. So, comes spinning on the inside, smashes there. He's got the refractions as well. If he wants to slow him down, they're going to die if this Whitebeard goes down. Now, Jayo in a little bit of trouble, but they won't keep going.
Radiant structures are fortified. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Radiant's top tower has fallen.
Yeah, and it kind of comes back to a little bit of this vision thing. Really, Moo? I don't think they're going to find this. Are they going to find this? Acid? Yeah, that's huge. The initiation range of Moo is actually massive when you look at the range of you can actually throw the concoction, I suppose, and combine with the blink dagger. So able to chase down Smash, and again, that does come because of the vision that has been provided here by Fluff, like being able to throw up all these tracks, like keep an eye on everybody. Not quite as good as it used to be, but still gets the job done in a lot of ways. And I wonder what's Van gonna go for now. He's going the Octarine. Oh man. Alright, well, see you guys in like an hour. Just gonna take a break. We'll come catch the game then. Nice.
Haste.
Yeah, and this is definitely a good trade here for the EWolves, at least. And it will force Moo to come back, but they don't get all the damage. Oh, that Omni Slash gets on 10, and it's all on Moo! He doesn't get swapped over to Whitebeard whatsoever! That's huge! So Jao comes in, he'll get Nightmared up. I don't think they want to continue this. Fluff rotating in, let's just get out, boys. We got what we came for. Maybe sacrifice M-God.
All is confusing.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Yeah.
Radiant's bottom.
Yeah, and really good prioritization there on the side of EWolves, going the Winter's Curse on top of the Undying, because it's unlikely you're going to be able to bring down Jao. And if you don't bring down Jao in that instance, then you're going to get the Tombstone out and a Soul Rip and everything like that. So the low risk play is definitely just take it down the Undying, get yourself a kill, and back out. And now, I don't know, with the Battle Fury, I would expect him to go for something like probably the Manta style. Keep split pushing these lanes, get the illusions going, create a lot of space here. But I don't know if, like, you've got this Nature's Prophet. Like, what happens when you start to go high ground is there will be a Blink Dagger from Monkeys. He's got it here, and he'll probably have the Force Staff by the time that they get there. So it is a little bit, I don't know, like, risky allowing this to go later. Like, Moo has definitely itemized early. Like, he did the exact same thing. But going into the later phases of the game, I don't know. I guess maybe you think that EWolves probably still has the stronger lineup. Like 45 plus. Yeah.
Triple kill!
is under attack.
That was hard work and dedication right there. Get that kill there for the side of Archon. So, yeah, you're right though. They were so close. Like, they were at that point where they were going to pick up more items. Like, it's only a Battle Fury on the jug. Like, he's got the Yasha now. I think he picked that up out of his stash after dying, I believe. I don't think he had it on his person when they went down. The first reveal of the Diffusal Blade in terms of like an actual team fight with it, I think you kind of forget just how much work it's actually able to do. And he absolutely crushed them. So the Archon core will be done though, and the split push game is ready to roll. There will be a tracker on Masoku though, and I can only imagine he will go down unless he does some serious terrain maneuvers here. And I'll certainly get a decent trade here, at least, from Iwo, knowing that they are inside the pit, since they, you know, can't see them anywhere. And they will send back Mr. Monkeys Forever, though, and it should be enough to at least stop any, you know, total damage here. Probably won't even be able to give a tower. The tower?
Roshan has fallen to the Regent.
Yeah, and again, Mu will head right towards that Assault Cuirass, and once again, they're also going to have a support with the Lotus Orb, probably coming out next year for Fluff. He's got the Perseverance. I'm not sure he's picked up anything else for it. Yeah, he has. He's got the Plate Mail and the Courier, so nearly done, and it's really good this game. I mean, what do you, everything the Bait has, obviously, it's very effective against that, and it's not like a Lincoln Sphere where you can, like, pop it, right? Like, your Bait, you're immune, not immune, but you're going to reflect all single-target spells for the full duration of your Lotus Orb. So that's going to be so good up against Omni Slash, because it does start the counter Slash, like, you can start going up against other stuff. It's going to be able to immediately cancel the Fiend's Grip. It's a nice little time here for him. Yeah, we talked about how that was the only way they were going to cancel the anything from the Juggernaut. This will be the only thing they'll have to cancel, like the Spin TP. So Mu's going to be doing a lot of these plays again, where he'll probably get Boots of Travel next. He's going to be moving around the map with the Blink and everything, and being able to stop the split push from the Juggernaut. And it also helps, of course, for someone like the Nature's Prophet when he tries to TP out after you already use the Concoction, because you have to use it to initiate. So, yeah, definitely the right pick here. Yeah, oh, monkeys.
Dire's top tower has fallen. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant structures are fortified. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
I am asked. Back to Earth.
Man, Monkey's the comeback kid this game. Now, two kills on top of Iowa after that start. Like, this is so much revenge after that poor laning phase you have to deal with this Juggernaut. Oh, did he get that off? I think he got that track off. Oh my god.
You distill dear essence.
Radiant's bottom tower has been denied.
Lens of Lenta.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Dire's middle
tower. Oh, the courier!
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Oh, that was the full Lotus Orb too. So sad. But yeah, Smash is at least probably gonna get back here. Maybe eventually. He's actually still not back. I thought he was making a beeline home. So Smash is still not back. They're gonna lose this tower. Like, there's an Omni Slash here, but the army. Oh, the army's dead. Doesn't want to go for it. Get the card yet!
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Death tax.
No. Moo killed the courier and the healing ward instead. But yeah. Smoke play pack. Avoid the deep slow van. Yep, and oh, mid get the dunk! And he let off because. Look, we'll just slam down. The wolf. God, look. The wolf. For sure, though. And me too. Survive that now coming in, though. And his way is run. Oh, yeah. Those submission trophies. It definitely one of the that we people stepping up lately. It's really possible. People I've seen, Magnum, like doesn't here. Like a lot of people tend to think like, oh, they have Nature's Prophet, and then so I'm gonna get more because he's gonna get an Agnims eventually and everything. But you only get the bonus damage from it from heroes. So I know it's a little interesting. I love Octarine Core. It's very similar to how you put it on like the offlane clockwork as well, because you're a player with really important skills. So that you want on like really low cooldowns. Obviously, it's not quite as good because you only have 3 actives and not 4. But I assume it will be the Octarine, yeah. And looks like I'll get the Bloodstone right now, the Soul Booster right now, rather. Oh, he's going back in.
Move
ogre, you're sorry.
Man, Smash has nothing. He's sitting on 3,000 gold, but it looks like he's the same items as like about, you know, 12 minutes ago or something like that. Saving up a lot of money here. Probably BKB, I imagine. Like, he just keeps getting bursted down here. Like, he gets stunned up by Mu, and of course with the Basher now, that's not going to help all too much. But just the overall control from the Earthshaker, it seems like it would be something that's going to be really important. And speaking of the Earthshaker, they're going to be able to spot out this Juggernaut here. Can we get... what is this going to be? Is this going to be dunk number 4 on top of this Juggernaut? Number 4? Can we go?
The dust return.
Haste!
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
Yeah, they actually have zero creep, like they can't go anywhere.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
I just don't even know, man. We've seen this a couple times. Like, we've seen the Moon Meander doing this when he goes in his little build and does it, and we've seen a couple, I believe Alliance did it a couple times too. It's ridiculous how much pressure you put on. At least they don't have kind of that second hero. It's the Jug and the TA kind of combined to be almost like one. It's like half a Naga, honestly, or an Alchemist. They can do a little bit of work, but the spin only works when you can actually see the magic stun coming, and that has not been working up against monkeys. I don't even know. Like, you're up against an Alchemist, first of all, so he's getting so much gold if he's actually the one who can get these kills, and he does have the Boots of Travel now, so if he just wants to head into a lane, and he doesn't have any AoE clear besides the Acid, though, so it's a little bit hard for him to really capitalize on, as we're actually going to see it right now. We'll see how much he can actually get. He can't get the stun off because they blocked him and cancelled his blink. That was pretty great. It's relatively hard for cleans up. It looks like there will be a fight there. They're gonna Omni Slash double monkeys though, and that Wipe almost goes out, but he goes up. There's last chance before the Desolator gets there. Dunk comes out from monkeys, got the low sword on top, protecting him. Mu has now entered the battle, got himself one kill. Smash, he gave it up in the middle, but oh my god, he's tracked out, found out, and Van down on the river. Come back up from the Aegis. Van still stuck down there. We'll get Spirit Lance, and Smash looks like he has abandoned the fight, coming over to the other side of the river. And I think Van is just gonna go down here. Tries TPO, but hey yo, Bash Lord still has concoction if they need it, but. That turned pretty quick. That looked kind of good. The opener Omni Slash. Oh, nice pings. Nice.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
Oh man, this, it gets so frustrating because you've built this combat build like for Mu and everything like that on one of the heroes. Oh, he's actually building an Agnip Scepter for somebody. That's gotta be... I would imagine it could be the Earthshaker, probably. I mean, Undying's kinda good, honestly, but... Probably the Earthshaker. Or maybe himself, just for the stats. Actually, you know what? You give the PL the stats. There, that's the play. It's the best one, I'm just saying it. But either way... you kind of have to play it like you get one creep wave, this is our creep wave. Like, there are many creep waves like it, but this creep wave is mine. And they'll get their auras, and they're just gonna have to march this creep wave into the base without Van killing it with, like, his ultimates. I think that's actually the play.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
I'm okay with kind of how he's doing. I'd like to see, like, rather than a Radiance or something for move, simply because without the Manta, it's not that great. I kind of imagine maybe going, like, a Mjolnir or something, getting rid of the SNY. I think you keep the Solar Crest. Maybe get rid of the Solar Crest. Oh, looks like he's getting rid of something, and he's gonna be giving the Aghanims right over to Whitebeard, so that's nice. But yeah, I'd like to see, like, a Mjolnir, just so he can guaranteed get the kills on the Treants, and they can't whittle themselves away from them. And he's gonna find that Smash up here.
Dire's bottom tower.
You know how we missed that fight because we were watching the bottom lane thing with Moo and the Treant, and then the fight by the Roshan pit? The cheese is still in the pit. There's a cheese just sitting in there. Thanks, Twitch chat. Yeah. Yo, props to you guys. Scout that stuff out right there. That's actually so great. That rarely happens. It's just so calm. I'm just like looking at the map and there's just Treants everywhere. He's got them all over bottom, he's got them in the mid lane. He's got his refresher in the stash because who needs it for anything other than ultimate, so he can just pump out more of these trees. They have a good wave top though. Are they? Alright, this is their time. I think they're just gonna leave the other lanes and just take this top and win the game. I think that's their hoping plan. It depends on the kills they get. Like, if they just get a really huge pickoff, like if Smash gets caught out or something like that, then the game's just over. Like, he has no buyback for, what, 4.5 minutes? I don't know. That's the big one. Then they can go for these tier fours and everything like that. But if he can kind of sit in the back line and maybe there's some control coming out from the Bane and some good Sprouts and there's still an Omni Slash sitting here for Iwo, I don't know. Like, it's a little bit risky because what if they die? Like, I'm sure they all have buyback. All right, none of them have buybacks. Okay, I thought that was just the dire side with no buyback, but no. So the entire range doesn't have buyback. So, I don't know if you. I don't think you can go tier fours in case you get wiped and Van N just trolls your base. He's like, oh, I'm just gonna go take everything. It doesn't have that much right click, I suppose, but there are many trees as you talked about before. I guess they're almost dead on bot though. Yeah.
Oh, hey.
Oh, sorry. Packet loss is done. We did it. It looks like maintenance is over. Well, I'm checking now. It was really bad, but it appears to be gone now. So hopefully we should be going soon. Just some Tuesday night Dota, man. Update night. Gotta watch out for that. But, you know, Major's throwing everybody off. Everybody's, you know, slamming in their games now. Just like, all right, Major's over. Back to work, everybody. Slightly, because luckily I'm, like, far, far East Coast. So I'm actually an hour ahead of Eastern time. So it was a little bit better for me. So it would be, like, 6 a.m. the first series started, because it was like 11 a.m. there, and so I got up at like 8, you know, a couple days just to watch games, so not too bad. Yeah, seriously, like, just done, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that was such an exciting final day. I got up and tried to not get spoiled. So I tried to watch, like, the active broadcast, right? So I turned on the Twitch page, and I'm, like, trying to cover, like, the Twitch headline with, like, one hand and try and navigate to the past broadcast so I can start at the beginning. But then when I did that, it still had the title as Grand Final Up Next, OG versus Secret. I'm like, fuck! And so I was, like, so excited, because I'm like, wow, they actually beat EG? Like, that's pretty cool. But, oh well. Oh, well, I mean, I feel like we need, like, a forestry degree to keep going on about this game. Like, honestly, there's trees, and they're pushing lanes, and then he plants more trees. And then on the other side, the other team happens to be playing a game of Dota 2. At least they're attempting to, but they can't, because someone has initiated a forestry course in the middle of the match. You know. Yeah. Teammates, it's like techies, you know? Like, the only person having fun in a techies game is the guy playing techies. Oh, we're going. I think we're good.
Dire's top barracks are under attack. Dire's top barracks has fallen. Radiant's bottom tower.
Oh!
What's this?
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant victory.
No, just well played. Like, they gave him the Alchemist the first game, and Mu had a dominating performance, and then they gave it back, and Mu had a dominating performance. Like, he's just all over the map. He's stunning you, he's taking down the supports was his main role. Like, he would just appear somewhere, and M-God was dead. Like, 0-13-8. It kind of says it right there.